Hello all, in this particular tutorial we will learn how to add a Windows target in Oracle Enterprise Manager OEM 13.5, which is also installed on Windows. So OEM is running on Windows and we are going to add a Windows target for monitoring or into this particular OEM. The software used for OEM, so the OEM is running on Windows Server 2019, it's a 13.5, and the database for OEM is Oracle Database 19c. The software used for target, this is the target server which we are going to monitor using the OEM, and that particular database is also hosted on Windows Server 2019, and it is Oracle Database 19c for Windows. Now, the high level steps, these are the steps that we need to do on the target server. So these are the steps that we need to do on the target server. We will be downloading the utility called Sigwin 64. I do not know whether you call it as Sigwin or Sigwin, whatever it is. So sorry about that. So Sigwin 64, we will be downloading this 64-bit. Then we will be installing that particular software into the C$. While we install that, we will choose these particular four packages: unzip and zip from the archive category, OpenSSH and OpenSSL from the net category. So these are the four packages that we will be installing. Then we will be modifying the sigwin.bat file. We will be adding this particular entry into the bat file. We will edit that particular bat file, and then finally we will do the SSH host config. So we will finally do the host config, and when we do the host config, we will say should strict mode no. Do you want to install SSHD as a service? Yes. And the value of Sigwin for the daemon, bin mode antisec. And then finally, we will start the Sigwin SSH process. Then once these are the steps on the target server. So download, install, modify the bat file, configure and start. Then we will add the host entries for both OEM server and the target server in the etc host file on both. We'll have to do this on both. Then from the OEM, we will deploy the agent or the target server, and then we will discover the database listener. But before discovering the listener or database, we need to unlock the account DBSNMP on the target server. So these are the high-level steps. Now that we have seen all the steps, let's go to our this is the target server. So I'm going to show you host name. This host name of this is Win19 database, and this particular machine is where there is a database. So let's connect to the database. So there is a database called Aura, which is running on this. So select name, comma, open mode from V$ database. And this is the machine that we will be adding into the OEM. So before doing that, as I told you, we need to download the Sigwin software. So go on the internet and say download Sigwin, and here you get this particular link. Let's click on that particular link, and we are going to download the 64-bit. So let's download that 64-bit, and the download seems to have completed. So we don't need the browser anymore. So let's click on this setup, run as administrator, click on yes, and next, install from internet, yes. And here we are going to change the name to just C drive Sigwin, remove the 64-bit all users. Click on next. Local package, that's fine. Use system proxy diff settings, that's fine. It's going to bring this URLs. Choose anyone. I'm going to choose the fourth one. Choose whichever works for you. Click on the next. It's going to go off the internet and it's going to download this particular packages for us. So right now it is downloading these particular packages, the Sigwin. So give it a minute for this download to complete. And that looks good. Now, as I told you, we need to install four packages. So remember that, as I told you, we need to install four packages: unzip, zip, OpenSSH, OpenSSL. From the archive category, these two. From the net category, these two. So let's go ahead. Let's click on this plus symbol. We are into the category. From the archive, we need to install two of them, unzip. So click here, choose the latest version, and zip. Click here and choose the latest version. So unzip is selected, zip is selected. We can minimize the archive one. Now we will go to the net category, and in the net category, we will choose two of them, OpenSSL, OpenSSH. So let's go scroll to that particular part, and here here is this. Open SSL is already selected, so I'm okay with that. Open SSH, let's drop down and select the latest version. So that's four packages. Click on next. Although we selected only four packages, but internally it is going to install these dependencies. So you can see zip, unzip, open SSL, open SSH. That whatever we selected, that is that. That is more than enough. Then it's going to go off the internet and download these particular packages. So right now, that's what is happening here. And while you can see here under the C drive, the Sigwin, and it's going to install all of that. So give it a minute for this particular installation to finish, because although we selected only the four packages, so there were multiple dependencies. It needs those other packages for it to work. So that's why it's going to take some time. So almost done. We are almost done. And we should be anytime finishing the installation. So that looks good. So the download is done. Right now it is installing. So that's done. Yeah. Create icon, add, this is your choice. Let's do that. Let's find. And now here we got. Now what we are going to do is the next part is we need to modify the sigwin.bat file. So here under the sigwin, you can see this sigwin.bat file. We are going to modify this particular file, and here we are going to add this particular line. So originally the file looks like under the set term, I'm going to add this particular line, and we will close that. We will save it, open it, and we will verify that particular entry is there. And as you can see, that particular entry is there. So that looks good. Once this entry has been added, what we are going to do now is we are going to launch the Sigwin. And when we launch the Sigwin, we are going to run the command prompt as administrator, and we are going to go to that particular location. And under that you will find this sigwin.bat. So I'm going to take that, and I'm going to press enter, and it does this configuration. And now we need to do the next part, where we need to actually do the SSH host config. So this is the most important part. So let's run this particular command, SSH host config. Let's run this particular part command. Let me minimize all of this. Yeah, and we are going to run this SSH host config, and it's going to configure the SSH for us. Should strict mode be used? I said no, we are going to say no to that. Do you want to install SSD as a service? Yes, we want to. Enter the value of Sigwin, and here we are going to give this bin mode anti-sec. So we are going to give bin mode anti-sec. That's done. So the configuration is done. We can safely exit from here, and we need to start that particular service. So, and I do not know what name the Sigwin has installed the service. So let's locate that particular service. Here you can see it is startup mode is automatic, which means the next time the server is started, it's going to start automatically. However, it's not running, so start that particular service. Once that service is started, we can verify that the port 22 is listening. So netstat minus an find str listen, look for port called 22. So there will be 1522, which is the database port. Let's see if the 22 is listening, and you can see 22 is also listening, which is the SSH port. So that looks good. So there's SSH port is listening. Now that's done. So now what we are going to do is we are going to create a directory for our OEM. So we need to deploy the agent here, OEM agent. So we are going to create a directory called OEM agent. You can create it anywhere. I'm going to create it under the C drive, Oracle OEM agent. So that's done. So I've created a directory. And the final part is the database. So here is the database. We have already seen this particular database. And what we need to do is we need to take a look at the user called DBSNP. This particular user will be used to monitor the databases. So let's take a look at particular, and you can see the DBSNP user account status is from DBA users is in the lock state. So we are going to unlock that account, and we are going to change the password. So let's do that. So let me copy this. Sometimes the copy paste doesn't work. So anyway, that's done. So alter user DBSNP account unlock, and I change the password also to password. The password is literally password, as you can see. And now if I check this account status, you can see it was locked, now it is open. So that's done. So all these settings on the target server is done. All the settings on the target server is done. And if I have forgotten, we can always come back. But I think all the settings on the target server is done. So let's go to the OEM server and now log into the OEM server. And we will log into the OEM server as a sysman. So we'll log in as to the OEM server as a sysman. And what we will do here is we will say setup, and we'll say add target. This is a two-step process. We need to first add the target. So we need to deploy the agent, and then we need to discover the database and listener. So add target manually. So we'll say setup, add target manually. That's what I have clicked here. So as I mentioned, it is a two-step process. So let me minimize all of this. So we are going to do two things. We are going to install the agent on host. So that's part number one. And then we are going to add using guided process, which is part number two. So first thing, we need to install the agent on host. So let's click on this install agent on host. So let's click on this. Here you can give whatever name. So let's say, I want to add Win19 database. So I'm going to add this particular host here. I'm going to say this. And then I'm going to click on add. And the name of the database, host, which is Win19 database, and platform, which is the Windows 64. Now, the next part is giving the, here it says that we should use the fully qualified or IP addresses. This particular machine is not part of the domain, so I'm not going to use the fully qualified domain name. I'm going to use the short name. It is going to work, but normally you should use the fully qualified domain name. So that's what it's saying. And I'm going to ignore that particular warning. So let's click on next. It's a Windows. We are going to use Windows Server on this particular host, 13.5 agent. Click on next if all looks good. And what we need to do, let's see if there are more. Yeah, so there are some things that we need to fill. And what we need to do now is we need to give the location. So this is the directory. This is the directory where we said we are going to install the agent. So let's give that. You don't have to give this. It automatically picks up this particular. I'm going to change this to this. And here, the named credential, I'm going to say plus. And I'm going to say SQL SA. And I'm going to give the password of SQL SA. And what is the SQL SA? This is an account, local account, which has got the admin rights. So this has got the admin rights. And I'm going to say Win19 database SQL SA. So I'm going to take that, click OK. And here I'm going to choose that particular. So otherwise I'll have to again do plus and I'll have to enter that. So instead of that, because I'm going to use the same account, this is fine. So what we have done, we have clicked on the plus symbol, and here I gave SQL SA, password of the SQL SA. And as I told you, SQL SA is a local account. It has got the login. And actually, in fact, I have logged in using that particular account. So if I launch the command prompt, you can see I have logged in using that particular account. So this is the local account, which has got the admin rights. So that is the account that we are going to use. I gave the account that SQL SA and the password of that account. So that's done. Click on next now. And it's basically on this particular host, it's going to install 13.5 under this particular directory. If everything looks good, click on deploy agent. Now, it's going to go through three different steps: initialization, remote prerequisite checks, and the agent deployment. So it's going to go through these three steps. Right now it is close to 1:44 a.m. So probably maybe 6 minutes or 10 minutes is going to take. So I'll pause this. I don't want to waste your time. So definitely I'll be pausing this particular video. But what I want to show you that let it initialize and show that it is successful. The initialization is successful. Let's wait for the initialization to be successful. So right now the initialization is happening. It's doing the remote validation. Then it's going to do the remote prerequisite checks. And then finally it's going to deploy the agent. So let's give it a minute. And let's wait for this to happen. So give it a minute. It should be done within a few seconds. It won't take much time. This is what basically when I, there is nothing happening and all that. And you can see the remote validation successful. So that is done. And now it says transferring agent software to destination host. So it's doing this second part. So let's take a look. Let's go to the server. And you can see we just created the OEM agent. We never created this directory. This is the temp directory. And it's right now transferring this particular agent, OEM agent, from the OEM server using port 22. So SSH port is transferring this and it's going to deploy this particular agent. So it's going to do this in the background. And that's what I wanted to show you. So that's what is happening right now. So let's wait. Let me pause this video and come back once the deployment agent deployment is completed. So I do not want to waste your time. So initialization is done. Remote prerequisite checks are happening. Then it will do the deployment. And then if everything goes fine, it's going to show that that's done. So let me pause and come back. So it definitely took some time. It definitely took some time. 144, I believe we started, 152. So close to 8 minutes, but you can see agent deployment succeeded on Win19 database, which is running on 64-bit. So Windows 64-bit. Initialization, remote prerequisite checks, and agent deployment, that's all done. And if I show you here, installation configuration done, secure agent done, collect log done, cleanup done. So looks like everything is done successfully. Now that agent is installed, we need to, as I told you, this is a two-step process. First, we need to install the agent. Then we will be adding the databases using guided process. So let's use this particular option, Oracle database listener, etc. So we are going to choose this, click on add and choose here. We are going to choose the Win19 database. This is the server, this is the database that we are going to use. So let's select that, and then we have selected that. Click on next, and what it's going to do now, it's connecting to the Win19 database and trying to find out Oracle Homes, under Oracle Homes, the databases, listeners. And now I have only one Oracle Home and I have only one database and one listener. So probably if everything goes fine, then it should list that particular database and it should list that particular listener, and that looks good. So you can see we got here one database listed and one listener listed. So I'm going to select the listener and I'm going to also select the database. Now here, this DBSNMP user we have already unlocked. So I'm going to say, give the password of that user, and I'm going to click on this configure and I'm going to remove this db.com. And I'm going to save this and I'm going to do the test connection. Let's see if it is able to connect. And the connection, test connection was successful. Let's do it one more time. The connection test was successful. So we were able to connect to that particular database. So, and we have selected the listener, we have selected the database. So click on next and don't save. So what it's going to do now is going to add this target, the database, and it's going to add this listener into the OEM monitoring. So save this. And if everything goes good, then you can see we have got one Oracle database and one Oracle listener added to our OEM. So that looks good. So we have, if I go now to the targets, all targets, we should have that particular database instance. And right now the target status is still showing that it is pending because we just added it. So it's going to take some time. And you can here clearly say target addition in progress. So right now that particular target is getting added. And the listener has also added. So it's basically, it's going to, because we just did that particular step, it's going to take some time. But however, it's going to discover this particular database, connect to that particular database, and finally add this particular database successfully. So give it a minute for that to happen. So I'm just waiting for that to happen. So give it a minute. I really do not like to waste your time when there is nothing that we can do except for waiting for the background process to complete. But again, guys, I don't have a choice. I can definitely pause this, but I really do not want to pause this. So give it a minute. Otherwise, if it is taking really long time, I think I should pause this, because so anyway, the timing is 1:56. If I come back within, otherwise what I'll do, actually I'll show you something. So let me click on, although it's still saying pending, but we should be able to connect. So let's go back to our database and connect to our database. So here, if I clear this and if I say describe V dollar control File. Yeah. Select name from v$control file. And here you can see there are two control files, control 01, control 02, under Aura data, Aura. Let's take a look. Let's connect to that particular database from the OEM. So let's click on that particular database. And let's go to the administrator. Let's go to the storage. Let's look at the control files and see. Let's connect to that. And here now it has turned up. So looks like it has done successfully. But anyway, whatever if checks we wanted to do, I'll just show you. So connect as a sysdba. And here you will be able to see control 01, control 02, CTL under D drive Aura data, Aura. This is the same location where we saw that files D drive Aura data, Aura, control 01 and control 02. And now if I go back, so if I go back to the targets, all targets, we should be able to see the thing. Let me clear this part. So let's close this. And we should be able to see that our database instance is up. As you can see, our database instance is up and our listener should be also up. So we have, with this, we have successfully added the Windows server. After adding the Windows server, we also added a database and a listener into the OEM. And to do that, we had to rely on a package called SigWin64. Because this particular package will allow the SSH connectivity, which is used by the OEM. So SSH port 22, which is used by the OEM to connect to the Oracle databases. OEM uses this. So we need to do this. So with this, I would like to say thank you for watching. In this particular tutorial, we learned how to add a Windows target on an OEM. In an OEM 13.5, which was also running on Windows, and we successfully discovered the databases listeners. Thank you. And at again, I would like to say, if you do like the videos that I'm uploading, if you do like the content that I'm uploading on my channel, do subscribe to my channel, do hit the like button. Thank you for watching and see you in next tutorial. Till then, bye bye, have fun, and let's see you in the next tutorial. Bye.